Good evening and welcome to the Whiskey Lover Society with me, Gert Retief. And today it's the conclusion part of a three-part series on the three whiskies that I bought, or three bourbons that I bought, and the small sample pack. It is the Evan Williams, Elijah Craig, and the Larceny. So in the previous three videos, I quickly reviewed them, giving my nosing notes, tasting notes, and what is my initial thoughts on them. As a quick reminder for people that did not see it, I will put a link on over here so that you can go have a look. So the idea behind this series is to take it out of the box, open it up, no research. I am a complete newbie. I've, like I previously stated, I had about 25 or 30 years ago, I had a Jim Beam, hated it, threw it down the drain, couldn't drink it. And the next one was maybe almost a year ago, 6-7 months ago, I had Eagle Rare, which I really enjoyed. So I thought to myself, it's a good idea to do a little bit more reviews. And so I bought this one to make sure or to see what it's all about. So I take it out of the box, I open it up, I put it in a glass, and I nose it and I taste it, and I have no idea what to expect. So this is going to be the final in the series. And I'm going to pick my favorite. So I have already poured them a while ago. So I have the Larceny, and I'm going to put it here in front of me so that I don't get confused. I have the Elijah Craig, a little bit left of the Elijah Craig. And I have the Evan Williams. So I'm going to just quickly go through them again. I just want to put my sample bottles next to it so that I don't get confused myself and give the wrong whiskey the best review. So if I start off with the Evan Williams. Now, the Evan Williams for me is a little bit like on the nose, it smells quite young. So it's got the, in Europe or in Scotland, when we have a whiskey that is aged for the minimum requirements, the three years, and sometimes 3 years and one day, you get that youthfulness, that the sharp alcohol type of notes coming out. Now I get it quite similar on the Evan Williams. So it does feel a little bit kick in the face, nosing notes. Other than that, nosing notes are a lot similar in all of them, with the base notes of the corn, which I get a little bit of the vanilla notes. I get a little bit of a butterscotch note. I get in one of them, the Larceny, I get a little bit of a raisiny note. And in the Elijah Craig, I got a little bit of a smoky note, but not like a smoke what we know, the peat smoke, but more from charred wood, that type of smoke that I get. So the Evan Williams, nice, but I think just that the strong alcohol nose to it puts me off a little bit. The Elijah Craig, love the colors. And again, I don't know if you guys even do add color, but it's a lovely color to it. And it's vanilla is so much more pronounced. If I compare that to the Evan Williams, I get so much more vanilla nose notes on it. And much sweeter nose. And I also don't get that hit of the alcohol, that ethanol type of notes coming out. So this one is quite nice for me. And then the last thing, I get now, I get a little bit of an orange note as well. And a hot sugar sweet. Quite pleasant. And I think it's also a good idea to give this time, like the Scotch whiskies, put it in a glass, cover it, and let it stand for 10-15 minutes, just to also get some oxygen in it, to give it a little bit more depth in flavor. So I poured these ones a while ago, and this one is really evolving for me. Not so much on the Evan Williams and the Elijah Craig, but oxygen on the Larceny definitely made a big difference for me. And I do like it. So at this stage, it's quite close between the Larceny and the Elijah Craig. And I must say, it's a difficult one. I'm not sure because on the Elijah Craig, I get a little bit more sweetness now. I do get all the nice cinnamons and a little bit of a cinnamon. The vanilla, the vanilla is fantastic on the Elijah Craig. And also a little bit of a dusty note coming out in the Larceny. Also on the Larceny, the vanilla notes is a little bit toned down for me. But it's so sweet on the nose. It's really difficult for me to decide, but of course I can't sit here for half an hour and waste your time. I need to make a decision, and I think it's the Elijah Craig. Oh, it's really nice. And I think that is because I do love the vanilla. I like anything with vanilla in it. I like even the room freshener. I always go for the vanilla. And it is so nice. So on the taste as well, it's just smooth, it's sweet, it's got the nosing notes. I get it in the taste, I get the caramel, I get a little bit of a toffee note, I get a little bit of the vanilla notes. It is so refreshing to smell something and you know that this is what you smell, this is what you're going to taste. In some of our scotches, most fantastic nosing notes, put it in your mouth and oak kicks your teeth out. In this case, I don't get that. So really nice. This is fantastic. So Elijah Craig, fantastic whiskey. You are the winner of this series. And I'm really looking forward to reviewing some more bourbons or American whiskies. And please leave a note in the comment. Which ones do you think I should buy? Which ones do you think is going to be much better than the Elijah Craig? And I'm looking forward to reading all of the comments. And also remember to like and subscribe. I'm still a very young channel. And on my way to the magical 1,000, which according to the analytics, it will be by 2050. So be kind, subscribe. Cheers.